Thought I'd give you a bit of a look at some problems I've had with 650 barrels, in particular mainly just a pre-unit barrel. What I tend to do with a pre-unit barrel is change it over to the three-piece oil ring, which is a 4mm groove in the piston and allows me then to put this three-piece scraper and two rails in place of a one-piece cast iron ring for the oil ring. Just the compression rings are no big deal. What the problem is with pre-unit, pre-62 or 50, 650s, 1950 to 1962, is they're an 8-bolt, as you can tell, and this distance here gets quite small. That's on a plus 60. The plus 40 is a little bit wider. But on a plus 40 9-bolt, this is a 9-bolt barrel, as you can see, that gap is quite significantly different. The 9-bolt pattern is the same as what they used on a 10-bolt, except, of course, the two middle ones, that's a 9 and then a 10 would be like there. So this distance here allows for an even bigger bore than a 650 at 71mm. These are 71mm standard for a 650. The problem, of course, arises with smoking, sometimes because there's, you know, it's not picking up enough oil out the bottom and the oil control ring can't do its job. And when you get to oversizes like plus 40 or even a plus 60, it's almost, well, plus 40 is sort of okay, plus 60 is, and you know, that's about as big as you can go. It won't control the oil because of the distortion. And what happens when these are so close, like all these, is they develop little high spots in the bore. Although there's none there at the moment because I've honed them all, but they get little high spot ridges just down in opposite each of the main bolt holes. And that little high spot then causes problems with that one piece cast, because the bore becomes, the rings sit on four little high spots when it's at the top. That won't allow a one piece cast to control. Well, the three piece oil ring doesn't seem to worry it too much, and it'll control that oil and keep it out of the combustion chamber. What I like to do though, when honed, I like to run a set of bolts around them, and then I've got a proper sun and hone, which you really need the proper adjustable sun and hone, and just concentrate a little bit around the top, you know, give it a full stroke on the hone, but just give it a little bit more at the top with the bolts in place, and that helps to take a little bit of the ridge off and gives it a much better chance of it working. Standards, 20s and sometimes 40s are okay. You get a bit bigger, 60s and 80s are almost impossible, but you can make them work with the three-piece oil. With a 9-stud, no problem. But here I've also got an A10. The A10, you wouldn't think would be a problem, because when you look at the bolt hole pattern, it's quite wide, isn't it, you know, out to the bore. So that's not usually a problem. But what is a problem with A10s and most BSAs is it's a gear pump and they tend to wet sump. That wet sumping is a bit of a problem, and start up, and it'll smoke like buggery. So with going to a three-piece oil ring on these things, and these are all 4mm in the groove, so the machining is such that you have to deepen the groove, like in this piston here, you deepen the groove just enough for the rings to actually be level with the edge of the piston on the tape, up on the taper here, and be a nice fit in the groove. So I do it on these 70mm, which is this one, right through to the 72, 73, whatever. If I'm going bigger sizes sometimes on the 9-stud, I might do it on the bigger bore, like an 80, plus 80 or even a plus 100. On the 63 to 71 650s. That's just my way of trying to make them a little bit nicer and reduce some of the oil burning that, you know, sometimes can be characteristic of a British twin, you know, in particular with the one-piece oils. Now, you've got to remember that when the factory brought out the 750, first up in 73, it was actually a 724 on a 75mm bore, not an actual 76mm bore. But anyway, they came out with a three-piece oil ring, basically what I've got here. and they were all good. And then they changed over to a one-piece cast, but it had a spring expander, and that worked, you know, behind the ring, and it worked all right. Now, with the triples, one of the first ones I did was went to an overbore. This is a 69 mil piston here out of a 500 twin, unit 500 twin, that is. And then I changed it to a four-piece oil, and that worked quite well. When I'm doing a big bore in a trident, as these two blocks here are, this one's set up with all the rings and the oil ring in place. You can see the 4 mil oil. If you don't do it when you go to a big block, basically all it is 650 pistons, 71 mil, 72 mil, whichever. The cylinders are, the old sleeves are dropped out and new sleeves made up to suit. Now this is, you can see this is a bit of a rough old sleeve, but they start life as either a blank casting or something that's made available via LA sleeves or similar sort of situations where you can get a hold of them. And they've got to be about 100 mil, I mean, sorry, 100 thou, which is 2.5 mil wall thickness. This is here. And they need this little bit of a lip on them, as you can see, so they don't drop through. Obviously, with an alloy barrel, anything that's alloy, you've got to make sure you put it, it's got a lip, as the factory did in the first place. So you can take a 650 piston, and you can do this to it. That's got a 4 mil groove already. And when you do a 4 mil, and if you're going to do 650 piston, big bore for a trident, while it's still in this, what you call a pot piston stage, in other words, the flat bottom, that's the time to do the groove, because you've got a flat edge for it to work against and to put in, set up in the lathe. So when you do that, then it doesn't hurt while you're at it to do the inlet valve cutaway, deepen it and bring it out as big as the valve, deepen it about a mil, because the trident valves are fairly large inlets. And then radius it. You can see that's her radius, and I've just copied that, the same radius, off what is a standard 67 mil trident piston, and do it on a linish belt. And by offering it up to the linish belt and using gram scales, then you can make sure all your three pistons are the same weight. But if you try to do a big bore, which I did early on, the very first one I ever did, I tried to use the standard 650 cast oil rings, oil ring, and it would not work, and it smoked like devil. But didn't take me long to figure out that I needed to do something about oil control, and then I got into the three-piece rings. I actually used three scrapers to start with, three or four scrapers, just filled the groove up with scrapers until I figured out, using rings from a guy called Mick Cassell years ago, this is back in the late 80s, he was able to supply these three-piece rings. And all these three-piece rings and other ones that I've done in the past have either come from Total Seal, which is in LA. There's Hastings and Grant also make these three-piece oil rings, and they're a 4 mil three-piece ring. They're not all not expensive really to get the rings and just use standard compression rings out of a normal piston kit. When I tend to do the big bores, I like to go with a decent set of conrods, and then I take the crank and shape. As you can see, the shape is tapered to the top, and it's tapered in by about half inch. In other words, the top here is wider than the bottom here to here by about half an inch overall, quarter inch off each side. That removes around 6 pounds in total off the crank and gives it a mild pork chop effect, which even in conjunction with these rods, which are, can either be Carrillo, or these in particular are NAP. I've got a couple of engines set up on Carrillo. That gives it a much more instant response and a quick settle down. A lot of tridents are known for the time they take to settle down. It's because the big heavy crank with the parallel sides just take forever to roll off the throttle when you want to idle. Not unusual to think that there's something wrong with your carburation when it's doing that, but more often than not, it's just a heavy crank. But if you lighten it like this, then it does snap. It'll snap back to an idle, as well as it'll pick up very quickly. So that's an more interesting way to set up a triple. Then you can balance them somewhere between 42 and 52%, whatever takes your fancy, and they work out all right. Anyway, that's triples with three-piece on a big bore kit. Even an A10 with a set of four-piece oils. Three-piece oils on a 4 mil, and There's a couple of 650 pre-unit barrels that have, you know, I've got about another half dozen in there on different projects and different stuff that have all been cleaned up and converting to three-piece oil, 4 mil. Anyway, thanks for watching.